Well, welcome back to Detroit right before puck drop. And Chicago Blackhawks hockey in high definition is brought to you by Xfinity, only from Comcast.
Well, rendering military salute. Singing the Star Spangled Banner today, Megan Campbell.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Welcome to the Joe, where the Red Wings are 14-5-4 so far this season. There's Corey Crawford, and that 2.13 is the third best goals against average in the entire NHL. How about his last four games? 3-0-1 and four goals against in his last four starts. And Jimmy Howard, another youngster, is at the other end. 23 wins is just one off the NHL lead. So he has had a great season up till now for the Red Wings. Our officials today, led by Ian Walsh and Chris Rooney. They're the referees, the linesman Scott Driscoll and Darren Gibbs. And we're underway in Detroit. Miller gets in there first. Campbell there with him, jammed it loose to Boland, and he sends it up the boards. It bounced away from a sunny long shot, went wide from Erickson. Now going to be held in by the Red Wings. Along Richter's deflected toward the corner. Draper put it in behind. Miller is checked by Boland, then taken back by Helm. He dropped it to line. Did it go out? It did. Rafalski couldn't quite keep it.
It's always good to remind Blackhawks fans tuning in and watching here at Joe Louis Arena these boards, and I know Joe Quenneville, Mike Kitchen, Mikey Havlin remind the players of how active the end boards are here at Joe Louis Arena. We saw in that last little dump in there, Pat, yes. I mean, it doesn't take a whole heck of a lot. And you got to be aware, not only offensively, but defensively as well.
Brower sends this in. It was checked by Cronwell as he did that. A little bit of a stare down after that contact, but Lidstrom now for Detroit gave it to Eves. Interesting here for the matchup situation. Mike Babcock with the last change goes with the Zetterberg line against the Jonathan Toews line for Chicago. Duncan Keith for Brent Seabrook. Up the boards to Patrick Kane, and out comes Toews. Jonathan Toews gains the line to the middle. Here's the shot. It's blocked and winds up back at center.
And that all started because of a real good play in the defensive zone by Duncan Keith to get the puck to his partner, Brent Seabrook, and caught two Red Wings in on that forecheck.
Now Mrazek is checked in the corner. Sharp trying to jam it back. Johnmerson's long one kicked aside by Howard. And the rebound hacked up the boards. And the Wings, Franzen, had his pass go off a leg. Now a steal. Here's Kopetsky. Thomas Kopetsky pulls up. And was checked by Erickson. Into the corner, Sharp. Patrick Sharp center was at the feet of Hossa. Taken back by Franzen. And he's able to clear it into the neutral zone. Patrick Sharp, 7 goals his last 11 games. A rude greeting from Justin Abdelkader, who flattened him with a great open ice hit. And then a pass rink-wide deflects out of play. Well, if you weren't awake before, you are now.
hit or be hit. And here, Sharpie trying to go to the outside, actually trying to get that puck to Thomas Kopetsky. And go back to that play. I mentioned, Pat, about the play. There's Duncan Keith. Watch the play. Two Red Wings will come in on him. He recognizes this. Nice little soft pass. Brent Siebert bypasses the next forward, Todd Bertuzzi, and the Hawks have something going good. Well, the less passing around the boards you can do against the Detroit Red Wings, it'll make life a lot easier in your own zone. Direct passes when they are there. Don't want to force it. It's okay to go off the glass. The glass and the boards are your friend, but sometimes it's much better to go tape to tape.
All right, now Stahlberg rolled it back into Red Wing territory, but it won't stay there long. Emerton wearing number 48. Corey Emerton in his first NHL game didn't get it very far. Skilly shot it up off the glass, and Tatar then got it out. Going to be chased down by Abdelkader. He's got the line. Justin Abdelkader with a wrist shot. Good block by Nick Leddy. It went back and forth from Rockford this week when the Hawks had a couple of days between games. Now Jordan Hendry in his eighth game in a row back as a defenseman. He finds a long lead pass to Pisani. He got away from one check, then Erickson met him in behind. Helm took it away. Came loose. Here's a pass back to Hjalmarsson. Campbell's one-timer. He whiffed on it. And Chris Draper chased toward the corner. They battle there, and now it squirts back to Hjalmarsson. Finally, Darren Helm able to roll it ahead, but Boland kept it in the zone. Now Rafalski chased it down. On their third chance, the Wings don't get it out. Good work there by Hjalmarsson to stay home. And finally dribbled back to center ice. But you don't often see Detroit have that much difficulty getting the puck out of their own end. Here's a steal by Kane. Patrick Kane kicks to the stick, turns in deep. Here's a wraparound. And Howard got a piece of that shot. Now taken back by Helm. He's checked, coughed it up. Bickle, or Taves rather, put it toward Kane. He shoots. Howard, point blank save. And the rebound of the Wings. And finally they clear. Now they might have a 2-on-1. Bertuzzi out of the reach of Zetterberg. Henrik Zetterberg with Bertuzzi in front of stuff attempt. Down low, Crawford. Rebound to Brouwer. Then Kane will drop it back to Seabrook. Patrick Kane will circle. Kane with some exciting news that he received this morning. We'll tell you about when we get a moment. In behind the goal, Brouwer with contact on Cronwell, trying to repay the hit from the first shift. Now Bertuzzi back up the ice, will dump it. Taken by Campbell. Hjalmarsson will leave it for Brian Campbell. Floats it ahead, Kopetsky. With a wrist shot, that didn't get through Soleil. And Ruslan Soleil banked it up the left wing board. Now they get it into the zone. Puck was knocked away before they could pull the trigger. Mrazek then dropped it toward the middle, but stole it away to lead for Hossa. And Mrazek, good job defensively to get back and prevent Marian Hossa from getting to the net.
Yeah, he was the guy that got that puck to Jonathan Erickson and fanned on it, and the youngster. Look, he was shot out of a cannon on that back check and denied a very quick Marian Hossa coming through the middle of the ice.
So obviously well schooled in Grand Rapids by one of the old Clydesdales. Kurt Frazier, the ex-Blackhawk, is the head coach in Grand Rapids, which is the American League affiliate of the Red Wings.
I think Fraz talked to him and told him about it. I don't think he showed him. I'll tell you that. I know that for sure. Now, maybe the great Troy Murray and the speed of the Clydesdales. I guess if you're the fastest Clydesdale on the line, I don't know what's that. I don't know if that's saying very much.
A rebound from Everton was hacked up off the glass. Now Abdelkader shot it off the side of the goal, then got it back. Abdelkader out to Cronwell, touched it across along Richard Kindle. Never got through. And back come the Hawks. Stahlberg with a long wrister. That's handled by Jimmy Howard. They battle in deep, and Cronwall is checked by Pisani. Puck came free of the Wings. Miller hacked it back the other way. It's going to roll to Crawford, so no icing. Bouncing back into the Red Wing zone. Here's Bickle to the backhand. He left it for Boland. sweeps it back. Letty across to Hendry. Here it comes. Good save by Howard with no rebound. Good net presence there from the bowling line. But Crawford gave him nothing to look at for a second chance. Corey Crawford has been tested at the other end. Made a good stop early, and we are scoreless in Detroit.
Teams from the city of Chicago are here, and special hello to the Huskies Pee Wee 2 team sitting in section 226 B row 17. And the terrific director of team services, Tony Ohman's son Logan, is in there. We understand we had a hat trick this morning in their 6-1 win. Way to go, Logan. And understand one of Logan's teammates from the Huskies team got hurt in yesterday's game, so we'd like to send get well wishes to Blake Camuel. And best of luck to the boys the rest of the weekend. Lots of teams here, Pat, from Chicago playing this weekend.
And they're here to watch two of the upper echelon teams in the NHL. Lockhorn today. Cromwell got in to save icing, tried to center it, picked off by Kane. I'm trying to remember the last time I saw a defenseman save icing, but Cromwell really hustled his way in there. Here's Taves trying to reach a loose puck. Brower then did. Lidstrom broke up the pass, and out comes Eves to Bertuzzi. Todd Bertuzzi dropped it to Henrik Zetterberg. On his backhand, trying to center the pass, broken up by Brower. Chased down by Duncan Keith. A long feed, he finds Taves, going to get in. Taves, the breakaway. Howard with the right pad. Jimmy Howard stands tall for Detroit. And Zetterberg to the other end. Centered Eves, shot it up off the glass. And it took a funny hop and went out of play.
A chance for Jonathan Toews, but a couple things happened. On that back check back, Troy Brower made a real good defensive play, as you mentioned. And Duncan Keefe's made two really good passes in this first period. There, Jonathan Toews with the opportunity. Trying to go low on Jimmy Howard. And Howard denies the captain. But the anticipation is once Duncan Keefe got that puck, where did Johnny go? He went to the open ice. And how often do we talk about it, Pat? And it's so important for young hockey players to understand the guys without the puck are as important than the guy with it.
All right, now Kopetsky throws it away. Mrazek centered. A good stay-at-home play by Campbell to break up the feed. It winds up back in the neutral zone. Ryan Rafalski goes across to Erickson.
No.
Mrazek sends it deep. Ryan Campbell gave it to Nick Jalmerson, tried to bank it out. Rafalski held it, a long shot just off the mark and picked up by Hossa. Hawks send it in, heading for a change, and Rafalski starts back for the Red Wings. 498 points in the wonderful career of Ryan Rafalski. Soon to reach a milestone. Hawks want to make sure it doesn't happen today. Bouncing puck taken by Seabrook, one hands it toward Bickle, and it winds up back for Kindle for Detroit.
I think the thing the Hawks have talked about, Pat, here in the last couple of days, and you know, with going really an oddity, going this long in between games during the regular season, the short shifts, you know, be real smart with the puck, make sure everybody gets into it, and let's not spend all afternoon killing penalties against a team that, even with all their injuries, still have a pretty good power play.
Good play by Brian Campbell to whack that out of midair. If it gets over his head and hits the deck, Helm was racing. But Campbell did a good job to not allow the puck to bounce.
Looks like he played a little badminton at some point.
I was thinking lacrosse or something like that, yeah.
Hit that little birdie back there.
Campbell for Chicago, up ahead for Jack Skilly. Stallberg picking up speed into the zone. Not a fight through a check by Rafalski. And the Wings come up with it. Erickson. Now carried in, a long shot, kicked aside by Goal! Went off the pad across the net. Everton in his first NHL game has just scored a goal with a 40-foot wrist shot, which certainly Crawford would like to have back. It's 1-0. What? for this 22-year-old kid, who in probably his third or fourth time on the ice in the NHL, has lit the lamp.
And I think what Corey Crawford is trying to do, he's trying to kick that puck into the corner. But see how active those boards are? Usually when a puck hits the boards like that, it'll stay up against the boards. But Emerton didn't have to break stride at all. Stepped in. Corey Crawford, obviously, you got to stop that one. But he was trying to do was to kick that one into the corner. Now, could he have stopped it, absorbed it, Pat, and made a stop and not tried to kick out a rebound? It was off to the side, but in that situation, that puck cannot go in the net.
Eves just makes sure to clear this one. It's going to go all the way for icing.
Well, fans, you want an opportunity to sit in between the player benches during a Blackhawks home game? Well, now you can. Bid on the CBOE seats through the online CBOE seats auction. Visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com for more information. Chicago Board Options Exchange is proud to be the presenting partner of the Chicago Blackhawks.
Well, with that, I'm going to call it a fortunate goal for Corey Emerton. Brian Rafalski now has 499 points. He picks up the lone assist halfway through the first period. The race here again for icing. Jalmerson has to scurry. Eves was hustling, lifted the stick from Jalmerson. It took the second man, Campbell, to touch up.
Pat, I got another shout out here. I'd like to say hello to Will Kelly of Lombard, a young hockey player with the Chicago Bruins. And got a chance to see Will the other night, Thursday, and he said, "Hey, Mr. Olchek, please, can you say my name on TV?" So, Will Kelly, there you go. Love the manners, too. Please, we'll get you a long way.
I've been working for years to try to get you to do that.
Pretty please.
Hey, Mr. Olchek. Please. All right, here's Bertuzzi rolling it out. Cronwall's up on the play. Put it across. Eves, a long shot. Crawford gave a rebound. And Campbell put it toward the boards. Erickson kept it in. Eves in deep. Rolled it back, Bertuzzi. Now Jalmerson had it bounce away to Campbell. He winds it around. That's going to be held in by Zetterberg. He tried to center Eves. Was knocked down as he wanted to shoot. Kopetsky comes out.
And Bertuzzi laid out Brian Campbell after that giveaway.
Jonathan Erickson starts back for Detroit. Franzen pulls up in behind for Hudler. Yuri Hudler had a terrific assist on the game-winning goal the other night for Detroit in overtime. Erickson gave it back. Hudler, a long shot, never got through. And bounce to Keith. Now Kane.
Yeah, that was a 4-3 win in overtime after Detroit had a 3-0 lead at one time, and the Blues find a way to get a point even though they lost on that goal you mentioned, Pat.
Detroit here with a 1-0 lead. 8 minutes left in the first. Kane fights his way into the zone. Taves carried on. Tried to center it. Bounce to Kane. Now Taves. Brower front of the net. The pass though deflecting out of the zone. Now Brent Seabrook. Cleared ahead. Bolin left it. Here's Bickle. He can shoot it. He shoots one. And a save by Howard. Rebound back to Henry. Good save. Howard rebound loose. Howard reaching. Could not corral it, but Cronwell did. And it's cleared ahead. The race is on. And Letty able to get back before Helm to that loose puck. So Jimmy Howard has had a marvelous start here for Detroit this afternoon. By the way, the Wings got some goaltending news that you will tell you about when, well, we can tell you about it now. Everybody thought that the Yevgeny Nabokov would wind up here in Detroit. Or at least a lot of people did. They were trying to get him signed. He had to pass through waivers, and the New York Islanders have claimed Nabokov on waivers. So Howard's going to be the man. Osgood's out for a long time. They'll need Howard to stand tall, which he's done so far today. Kopetsky played for several years here in Detroit. Wings on one side, another former Red Wing, Marion Hossa's on the other. Beat with the Sharp in the middle. Mrsak had it taken away by Chalmers, looking to hoist it, did get it out. And Erickson cleared it into the zone. Mrsak's long wrister blocked by Chalmerson. And Nick Chalmerson the other day had six blocks against Nashville. Hossa hearing it as he carried the puck. Now Kopetsky's long one fought off by Howard's blocker. Kopetsky tried again. Another save by Howard. And then hit escape comes back toward him. He's able to cover it up.
Well, the Hawks have done a real good job, Pat, here through the middle of the ice. You think about the Bickel chance. He got it from Bolin. The Taves breakaway from Duncan Keith. And again, the entry coming through the middle. Good speed. Simple play there by Thomas Kopetsky. And there you love Sharpie going right to the net. And Hossa was there initially. And Jimmy Howard's had to make a couple of good stops here in the first.
Has he ever, though? Wings have been outshot 11-4 in the game, and they're leading. And a pretty good number of those 11 Chicago shots have been good opportunities. Eves for Zetterberg. Seabrook cleared it to Patrick Kane. Now Taves checked by Lindstrom. Bertuzzi came to take it away. And the six-time Norris Trophy winner, Nick Lindstrom, clears it up the boards. Zetterberg stripped of it at center. Here's Henrik Zetterberg. Into the zone, Chris Draper looks back towards Zetterberg. He was well covered by Seabrook. Now they fight for it along the boards. And Patrick Kane had it but couldn't advance. And eventually it deflects out to center ice.
A hit by Seabrook on Draper.
Duncan Keith's long one soaked up by Jimmy Howard. 5 minutes remain in the opening period. The Wings have the lead. They call Hockey Town, Detroit, Michigan. We mentioned this early in the broadcast. Haven't had a chance to get back to it. Patrick Kane with some interesting news that he received this morning.
Yeah, he was going to be one of the alternate captains in Raleigh for the NHL All-Star Game. He will be on Team Lidstrom. And also Marty St. Louis, the other alternate. And for Team Stahl, that's Eric Stahl with the Carolina Hurricanes. Mike Green and Ryan Kessler is having a terrific season out in Vancouver, so congratulations to Kaner, one of the alternate captains for Team Lidstrom.
Here's a one-timer by Seabrook. Howard saw it all the way, made a good stop. And now they fight for it, and the Wings come up with it, but a penalty coming up against Detroit. Patrick Sharp was taken down. This the first penalty of the hockey game.
Well, Todd Bertuzzi in the box, but the Blackhawks with some great movement here. There's Duncan Keith over on the right side. And Brent Seabrook, recognizing that, moves to the other side, and he's a one-time situation. There you see Bertuzzi. Upending Sharpie. So the Hawks with a couple of real good opportunities, and I like the movement on the back end there with Keith and Taze. Excuse me, Kane and Seabrook. With a good shift down low.
Hawks power play 3 of the last 13. Seabrook for Taves. Spins it in deep. Kane's touch pass never got to Hossa. Went off a skate instead. And now Taves rolled it back to Seabrook. Patrick Kane could not pick it up on the boards. Aaron Helm rolled it loose. A clearing attempt. Gets what wound up out of play after deflecting. Marion Hossa, since coming back from a while with injury, has played 11 games, 2 goals, 5 assists. So far from the torrid pace he had set early in the season. And So you see his overall season numbers there, just under a point a game. And a clearing attempt bounced away from Campbell and out. Campbell and Keith have Boland, Kopetsky, and Brower in front. Thomas Kopetsky for Dave Boland. He was well covered. It's pushed back toward Campbell at the line. Now Keith. Troy Brower into the corner for Boland. There's Keith with a one-timer tip. It deflected wide. Picked up by Campbell. A wide open Keith looking for a lane. A long shot goes off a stick. Oh, tough one. A play by Troy Brower. And David Boland had a tap in. And then a confrontation after the fact. But the Blackhawks have tied it with a spectacularly beautiful power play strike.
We talked about Davey Boland in the open. And the Hawks doing a nice job of moving. There's Brian Campbell. He gets his puck back to Duncan Keith. And the shot is deflected by Drew Miller. And Troy Brower knows exactly where Davey Boland is. A 2-on-0 down low. Soleil has nobody. And a little shot by Boland on Soleil. And it's Soleil with a left right to the chops of Davey Boland. We talked about the power play, Pat. And it's just a matter of time. Love the movement. Love the pursuit of the puck. And that's the biggest key. You can have great talent. You can have great puck movement. Guys that can score and pass, but it's the willingness to track down loose pucks. Campbell was the guy that got the loose puck, got it back to Dunk. The puck ends up in the back of the net.
Everton, that is pass, deflect. Oh, a shot out of play, penalty. Coming up here against the Hawks. Jake Downs, Eddie said the glass is your friend, but you got to hit it from the defensive zone, and that one was lifted directly out of play.
Pressure along the boards. And good play there by Brian Campbell. There's two Blackhawks there. Jake Down realizing, I think he actually knocked that puck out of midair. I don't think that puck was on the ice when he sent it out, regardless of the way of game. And Red Wings will get a second power play here this afternoon.
Without a power play conversion in four games, the Red Wings, nothing out of nine over that stretch. Rafalski toward the middle. Eames goes down low. Zetterberg with a backhand shot, handled by Crawford. Rebound in behind to Seabrook. Able to pull away from a check, and Lidstrom a good keep. Eames had a jump free. Seabrook has time this time, and he clears it. Nicholas Lidstrom leaves it for Henrik Zetterberg. He steps in. Heaves to Zetterberg. He looks down low. Franzen missed the pass. Now Lidstrom's got it. There's the Zetterberg looking to center. Comes across. Rafalski. Boy, he had Crawford down and out. I'm not sure he saw that. He tried to make a feed. Here's Lidstrom. A shot tip. Good save on a redirect. Corey Crawford stopped a shot that was deflected.
Oh, what a tip there by Patrick Eaves. And you're right, Pat, there. Corey Crawford down. I think Rafalski realized that and then tried to shoot for a stick. And there's a great stop. I mean, that puck's coming off the stick of Nicholas Lidstrom. Probably about 95 miles an hour. Patrick Eaves is able to get a stick on it. And Corey Crawford, at the last minute, has to readjust and make a left pad save.
All right, now Lidstrom with 45 for the power play. Hudler to Cronwall. Sends it across. Here's a shot. Fired up high by Abdelkader. Game back to the boards. Boland hit hard by Cronwall. But the Hawks do follow up and clear it. Nicholas Cronwall dropped it back to Hudler. Hudler dropped it back to the line. Rafalski to Cronwall. There's Rafalski. No lane. Good shot blocked there by Pisani. The counterattack led by Brower. He's got Pisani with him. There's the pass. A shot. Good save by Howard. Fernando Pisani, a terrific shorthanded bid set up again by Troy Brower. He was the guy who executed a wonderful pass to give Bolin an empty netter. And nearly gave Pisani a strike with a shorthanded opportunity. Miller with a shot. Well wide. The Hawks penalty over. Both teams at full strength. Miller put it into the corner. Chased down by Toews. Now Campbell had a problem with Helm. He got help from Hossa and Hjalmarsson. Let his pass go off a leg. Great steal by Toews at center ice. Hossa gets into the zone. That's ruled to be an offside play.
Let me go back to that play, Pat, from our Harris Telestrator. Here's where the puck is. I want everybody to watch the activity of Fernando Pisani. Passing lane, stick, make yourself look big, take away a passing lane. He blocks the shot, and then Troy Brouwer's off on a two-on-one opportunity. Great pass here by Brouwer. Waits, gets it to Pisani, and then the left pad save by Jimmy Howard. But the block shot, you talked about Hjalmarsson, Pat, earlier.
Yeah.
Small thing like that, and this is an area of concern for the Blackhawks. They've worked a lot on it all year long. They've had the last 5 days to talk about it, and those are the little things. And Fernando Pisani paying a price of taking away the options for a pretty good power play guy in Brian Rafalski.
The time wind down in the first period has come to an end here in Detroit. The Blackhawks with 15 shots in the opening frame today. The Red Wings credited with 8. But maybe news that's as good as any. The Hawks late in the period killed off a power play. PK has been the problem all season long. They enabled this visiting team to stay even in the game.
Hey, Pat, we'd like to send out special congratulations to that
yes,
man right
sir.
There. Gapper, Mike Gapski, going into the UIC Athletics Hall of Fame, a lifetime achievement award for Gapper.
As an athlete?
To help the athletes.
Okay, yeah, that's right.
And Gapper way back in the late 70s and early 80s, we'll just call it, graduated in phys ed and a degree in the highest honors in 1982. Gapper was assistant athletic trainer there for the Flames for 3 years before being promoted to the school's head athletic trainer position. So to Gapper and his family, congratulations. Just not only a great trainer, but just an even better human being. So way to go, Gapper.
Absolutely. I mean, he's great at his job, and that's very important. But you mentioned the critical area of being a great human, and I believe that's the reason he's lasted with the Blackhawks as long as he has. Here's Dave Bolin off the opening face. I'm trying to center one. That's deflected in behind. Then squirts to Hjalmarsson. There's Campbell. Here's the shot. Got a save by Howard. And again, no rebound.
Hawks have had a lot of that type of play that we just saw. D to D, partner to partner, opening up those lanes. We saw it on the goal with Campbell getting the puck to Duncan Keith. And the Hawks continue where they left off, Pat, in that first period. Look at all the people there. Net presence, you said that probably 4 or 5 times in that first period. And that's got to make the Blackhawk coaching staff feel awfully good of seeing that net presence, hungry for pucks, and shots getting through to Jimmy Howard.
Misfire and a pass attempt was stolen by Lidstrom, but that was offside play.
Pat, I mentioned that there are a lot of hockey teams here in from Chicago just playing in different tournaments and games. I'd like to give a special shout out to the Chicago Mission Squirt Team. Tyler Carpenter and his team are here, and also the Crystal Lake Mites. A young player by the name of Ryan Ryan, believe it or not.
Bertuzzi to the long one. That didn't seem to get through. Eaves touched it in deep. It jumped away from Zetterberg. And they fight for it on the board. The Hawks come out. Patrick Kane carries. Kane drops to Keith, a one-timer, in and out of the glove. And Kane just had it jammed away by Eaves, or he might have had an opportunity. Bertuzzi triggers it out to Zetterberg. Henrik Zetterberg, good back pressure there by Duncan Keith. And Patrick Kane now has it. The Wings Move back in. Jan Mrzak. Oh, Keith Turner the wrong way. Here's a shot. And a save by Crawford. I said to Keith Turner the wrong way. He seemed to get stuck on his one blade and got himself out of position. Back at the other end. A whistle. Do we have a penalty?
Pat, you're mentioning about Duncan Keith from our Harris Telestrator. There's Duncan Keith. Watch the play. Not once, but twice. Here's the quick stick on Zetterberg. Now watch the other extra effort there. I believe that was Cromwell jumping into the play as well. So a couple of good defensive plays there before that opportunity for Mrzak coming down those right wing boards.
Now the wings get in. Hudler spins in the corner, dropped it back. Rafalski, a long wrister. Crawford kicks it aside. Campbell unable to get it out. Hudler again. This one escapes him, and Campbell takes over. Back comes Marian Hossa. It's jammed off his blade. Lines up back at center ice with Patrick Sharp. Campbell moved it ahead. It bounced to Sharp. He whacked at it. And a save by Howard. Hossa to the corner and jammed away. And now Tatar back to the other end. But Nick Letty cut across. And he was hit by Abdelkader. Jordan Hendry sends it up an open wing. This one will be held in. Oh, Everton missed it. And the Hawks get out. Kopetsky to Dowell. Dowell pulling up. No late man available, and Abdelkader got it out of there. Ruslan Saleh for Detroit. Hit it back around the boards. It comes all the way out to center, and Thomas Tatar clears it into the Hawk zone. Abdelkader's wrister off the stick of Letty. Out of play.
Actually, I think I had that for service day room last night. Steak Tatar, wasn't it steak? Oh, no, wait, that's something too. Well, Hawks fans, don't forget to visit the WGN Games Sports Game Zone, brought to you by Four Seasons Heating and Air Conditioning. 5 days has been too long. Go to WGNTV.com and click on the WGN Sports Game Zone for special up to minute stats and info designed to give you everything you need to know during the game.
Now in behind the goal, the wings. Mrzak had his pass. Go back to the line. Long shot blocked by Campbell to Miller. Now dug out. Helm rolled it back. Kindle, a long flip shot easily into the glove of Corey Crawford.
And a welcome to Danny Colbert and Pavel.
Little faceoff to the right of Corey Crawford. You see his numbers in the month of January. But again, we mentioned this earlier, his last four starts, 3-0-1 and only four goals against. Of course, he had back-to-back shutouts in the midst of his last four outings. Draper working the board, trying to send a quick shot. Crawford soaked it up. No loose puck. Ryan Bickell against the Red Wings has played 8 games in his career, has 3 goals against Detroit, so he's not unhappy about seeing the winged wheel on the Chicago schedule. Had a big game the other night against Nashville, a goal and an assist. It was +2 in his role as the left wing on the checking line, the so-called checking line with Bolin and Pisani.
It's such a bonus, Pat, when you are able to trust those guys and play them head-to-head against the other team's top off. Offensive guys when the matchups are allowed and you want to go with it, the strengths of your club. But first job really is when you're playing head-to-head like that is don't get scored on, but then when you can contribute 3 and 4 goals like those guys did the other night against Nashville, it's a huge bonus with the 2 goals by Bolin and the 1 by Bickle.
Cronwall. Checked by Toews. Kane stole it, then Seabrook with a long shot that's off a stick. Bertuzzi cleared it to Cronwall. He shot it to the near board. That one held in. And now Nicklas Lidström sends it back into Chicago territory. This one's going to be icing against the Red Wings.
Well, the Blackhawks are celebrating Education Day on January 25th when the Hawks take on the Minnesota Wild at 7:30. First 10,000 fans receive a Blackhawks binder presented by the University of Phoenix. And all fans are encouraged to bring in unused school supplies at the game for a chance to win Blackhawk prizes. Tuesday night, Hawks and Wild.
Wall cleared it up the boards. Eaves put it high into the air. Sharp kept it in. Now it's cleared for Zetterberg, but jumped off his blade. Marion Hossa steps into the offensive zone. Hossa pulls up, shooting. A save by Howard. Rebound is loose. And Hossa got to it in the corner, working against Lidstrom, who took it down, pushed his feet from under me. They play on. In behind, Sharp to Campbell. He's hit hard in the corner. And now the Wings take control. Mrazek with some speed, fires, and off the stick of Campbell, out of play.
He can really skate down, Mrazek, skating through that middle of the ice. You made mention, Pat, of the play Nicholas Lidstrom made on Marion Hossa. And there his stick gets right under his skate blade, knocks Haas off the puck and off his blades.
You get a little more leeway when you won six Lawrences,
yeah,
don't you?
I guess that's kind of the life that maybe a great Greg Maddux or Rick Russell. Instead of painting the corners, you can paint the black for about 2 or 3 inches to the outside, right? So I guess that comes with respect and six North trophies and being one of the captains at the All-Star game. I don't think there's any doubt about that.
And Fergie Jenkins was happy about it. Being that way.
I don't know why Rick Russia popped in my head there. Well, I wasn't gonna say Paul. I know that.
All right, here's Hendry looking to keep it in. He was checked by Erickson. Stahlberg to the corner. Rolled it up the boards. That's when that one is picked off, and Tatar sends it ahead. Advocator well covered by Nick Leddy.
Nice play.
And the Hawks get it back. Here comes Skilly. Poke check right at the line. That'll result in an offside whistle. 6 minutes have been played here in the second. We're still tied in Detroit.
This puck has got to get in deep here. One little extra move. You got Jake Dahl flying down those right wing boards with good speed. Good play by the Red Wings. Jakob Kindle with a nice play. I know what Jack's trying to do in that situation, but sometimes less is more. You got two defensemen standing up. You got great speed. Chip it in behind him. Jake Dahl doesn't have to stop. You don't have to try to make that extra move. And the situation there for Jack Skilly to next time to know it's okay to chip and chase every once in a while. You fire that puck into the end boards, Pat, and you're like passing it to yourself. Yeah. You might get it.
Well, you set it off, and then you're right. I mean, these are hot boards, so you can actually make a pass yourself easily from in behind a bank pass from behind. Then a steal by Helm. Bergstrom rebound, open net. Oh, and they pulled it through their legs, and they couldn't get it to the goal. Miller had an open net. Tried to execute a drag move back through his legs to get rid of a shot. Oh my goodness, that'll be interesting to see that one again. After a Chicago turnover, a Detroit flurry, but the game remains tied.
I believe that was Fernando Pisani that gave that puck away. Tried to pass it blindly in the middle of the ice, and the Red Wings were right there. And remember, that stop there by Corey Crawford.
Seabrook will look back toward Keith. Duncan Keith put it up ahead for Brouwer. He finds Seabrook. Brent Seabrook going wide, shooting. He shot it wide. Keith will keep it in. His wrister is stopped by Crawford, by Howard. Rebound came to the side of the goal, and Jimmy Howard will cover it there.
What an opportunity for the Detroit Red Wings. As it was Fernando Pisani trying to pass that puck, skating one way, throwing it back to the middle of the ice. And Darren Helm was the guy that stole that puck. It's almost that situation, Pat. You know, you got that blind spot in your car, and you're, especially when you're a left winger skating towards your goal, that blind spot on the right side, you can see some. You can see like 40% of the rink, but the other 60 you can't. So if you look to go and cut over in that other lane without really checking that blind spot, you know what could possibly happen. That's what happened to Fernando Pisani. We're going to get a chance to show everybody the play, but on that situation, you're better off just to eat the puck on the boards or just shoot it back around and keep it along the least dangerous spot on the ice around those boards.
Duncan Keith has been a +5 in his last four games. Gets this ahead to Sharp with a wrister. Howard makes the glove save.
Get the paper, the playoff paper five pack, that is. Get 5 wins games, the Detroit Tigers ticket voucher and more, starting at $150.
Well, the Blackhawks entering play this afternoon, 9-7-4 on the road. So a lot more road activity coming up for this team, particularly in the month of February. I think they played only 4 home games the entire month of February. There's a long 6-game Western swing again involved early in the month. So they've done pretty well on the road. They're going to have to keep that up in order to stay in a playoff spot in the West. Advocator. Lidstrom was the first man up the ice. Advocator couldn't find a passing lane as the wily veteran D was looking to spring himself for a breakaway.
Maybe he's trying to impress his alternate captain on the ice.
Bertuzzi is going to arrive first. Seabrook there to meet him. And cleared it up the boards. Taken by Kane. Brouwer carries on. Troy Brouwer for Duncan Keith. He couldn't get rid of much of a shot. Keith touched it across. There's Letty with a wrister. Off the mark. And Brouwer bangs the boards. Then Taves came up with it. Hendry to the corner. Now Taves dropped it back. Jordan Hendry across to Nick Letty. A hot pass deflects to the corner. Stahlberg there. And the Wings finally able to get it out. And now we're going to have a Hawks. Oh, no, a Detroit penalty coming up. A board battle. And it may be Abdelkader in a retaliatory move that puts his team shorthanded.
Yeah, the hit to the back of the head on Nick Letty. Not a good penalty there by Justin Abdelkader. Yeah, right part of your screen right there. We're going to go back to that play, Pat, by Fernando Pisani. We're going to let it roll. Stop it here. Now, here's Fernando Pisani. Talk about that blind spot is right in this area. Watch the play. Bernardo trying to get that puck over to Brian Bickle again. And there's a chance. What a stop. And then right after that, Drew Miller has that chance you were talking about, Pat.
Here's Brian Campbell. Up ahead to Bickle, then Keith. Boland. Kopetsky, a tippy scores! Thomas Kopetsky, a redirect of a David Boland. Hot pass. Then the Blackhawks, with their second power play conversion, have a 2-1 lead.
15 seconds in to the power play. And as Patrick Kane told us in that first intermission interview, 2 units. And here, Keith to Davey Boland. I think Boland just trying to get this puck to the blade of Thomas Kopetsky. And look at the reaction of Kopetsky. Boy, off the stick, off the skate as well, and in behind Jimmy Howard. But Boland was able to get that puck by the defender, and it beats Jimmy Howard along the ice. That looks like a good goal to me. I think there's a little hesitation here to drop this puck. And there was a directing motion, I think unintentional, by Thomas Kopetsky, because he had his stick down there, Ben. He's just moving his skates. There was no distinct kicking motion at all. But the league just wants to make sure they did see it go off the skate. They want to make sure. And another power play goal for the Hawks.
This puck is out of play. We've come to the halfway point of the second period. Blackhawks goals from Bolin and Kopetsky by way of a power play have the visitors in front.
It's time to open our season ticket order of the game.
Send a special shout out and a belated happy birthday to the great Len Casper, one of the voices along with Bob Brenly for Cubs baseball. Understand Len had a birthday yesterday and he's watching back in Chicago. Hopefully his workout is going well and we're making the time go fast for Len.
Great guy, a huge hockey fan, and terrific baseball broadcast is going to be honored in Rosemont. Pretty soon, here's Henry. He couldn't get that one through. Miller made a nice shot block. Now picked up by Bickle. His long one is handled by Howard with a juggling save. By the way, other NHL action today finds New Jersey ahead of Philadelphia early in the third period of their game in Philly. The Devils have a 2-1 lead over the Flyers, who will be in the United Center tomorrow for one of those great 11:30 starts. But by the way, we're watching the two longest rivals in the NHL play today.
Right.
Of course, you know what happened last spring and the rivalry developed with Philadelphia. Then I believe there's another game on the Chicago sports scene tomorrow afternoon between the Packers and
the Bears. Go Bears.
Go Bears.
Best of luck and tune in to the Hawks game and then check out the Bears in the afternoon.
A steal by Tate. Oh, he tried to go goal mouth. Kane off the post. Oh, they're going to call it a goal. That's being called a good goal by Ian Walsh. It looked as if it drew iron, but Patrick Kane, according to Ian Walsh, has put the Hawks up two.
Boy, the way that puck came out, Pat, I did not think that this puck went in. Now on that look, slowing it up. And Ian Walsh had great position, right under. Yeah, off the crossbar and out. That is no goal. Just the way that the puck came out, Pat.
I was really surprised. I'm like you, Eddie. I was really surprised to see the referee point at the net.
Right.
And we're going to get another look or two at this. Really, there's no doubt about this at all. It's still a 2-1 game.
And I think in this situation, Pat, where Ian Walsh is looking, he's in great position. It almost looked like on that look, it's off the crossbar and out. And on the overhead, like in this situation here, the high look above Jimmy Howard. But watch this puck. It almost seems like it rides across. And then almost like it's kissing the crossbar right across, and I can, you know, see why in that situation. Here's the call on the ice.
So it remains 2-1. Bit of a huddle going out of the blue line.
Probably where the faceoff should be in this situation.
Well, the Wings very unhappy. It's still being put down in their zone.
I mean, what's kind of lost in this, Pat, with that puck off the crossbar and review and everything else, Johnny had a chance to fire that puck initially. It worked itself to the middle. Troy Brower with a great pass. Kaner with that opportunity. But how often do you get the puck within 10 feet of the goaltender? Nobody in between you and the puck. And the goaltender, excuse me, I think Johnny's got to put his head down and just bury that puck. I know he's trying to get it all the way over, and the Hawks almost were rewarded. But in that situation, Johnny's just got to fire that puck.
And with start of the sequence, really a dreadful Detroit turnover, which would have been a really deflating play for the Wings had that resulted in a two-goal deficit. But it's still 2-1 Chicago with 8.5 left in the second. And Troy Brower hacks this one into Detroit ice. Lidstrom on it. Now the Wings start away. Lidstrom put it into the Blackhawks zone. Franzen's touch pass into the slot. A tip. They tried to maybe make one pass too many. They tried to go goal mouth for the feet. It didn't work out. Hossa chasing it down in on Eriksson. Kopensky. Had it taken away. Mrsak comes out 2-on-2. Jan Mrsak left it. A long shot goes wide from Hoodler, and back come the Hawks. Sharp has got some speed. But Erickson able to rub him off on the boards as the Wings start the counterattack. Mrsak dumped it. Dowell tipped it back out. This one hit somebody, went into a bench area, so the whistle sounds. By the way, I mentioned that Hawks game tomorrow at 11:30, the faceoff in the United Center. Our NBC friends will have that one for you. The good doctor and Edzo will be ringside for the Hawks and the Flyers in a Stanley Cup rematch tomorrow. Late morning, right around the time you're starting brunch. Here's Bickle. He couldn't get a bouncing puck under control. And now the Wings come back. Kindle sends it in. Corey Emerton, in his first NHL game today, scored his first NHL goal. He could not pick this off the end boards. And now Emerton dumped it in. Crawford will go down for a whistle.
That's pretty crazy, Pat. You talk about the Blackhawks schedule over the course of, you know, not playing since last Sunday, a couple days off for the boys, and now you play Detroit, Philadelphia, who I think is at the top of the heap when you talk about the overall season that they've had and where they've added depth. I think Paul Holmgren saw one of the deficiencies in the Stanley Cup final was their fifth and sixth defenseman against the Hawks depth last year. They went out and got Andre Mazaros, who's really a legit top four. They got Sean O'Donnell, who's a real good experienced defenseman to play in that sixth spot. You play back-to-back games against two elite teams. Now, we know Detroit has been decimated by injuries, and the Blackhawks have had their share, but then you play Minnesota on Tuesday at the United Center, and then you've got the 5 or 6 days off for the All-Star break. So just, you know, goals and streaks, and the Blackhawks have had just, you know, their share of a real strange schedule over the course of the season, and all the guys and coaches that really don't mind the time off and allow some guys to, you know, breathe a little bit and get some bumps and bruises healed up a little bit.
The puck rolling to Crawford, the fans hollering for a penalty as Helm, as they tried to work and give and go, Helm went down, and neither referee put his arm in the air.
Play was along the near boards. And there's Darren Helm. I think he just toe picked. Brian Campbell was in the area. There's no doubt. That's not call. There's Darren Helm. He gets a little bit of a whack there by Campbell stepping up. And yeah, he just toe picked. His ice gets a little slippery out there. I used to blame the blue line. As every time I cried, it raised.
Cronwall, good save. Crawford with the left pad. Now Bertuzzi left it in the corner. Zetterberg could not come out with that. Cronwall kept it in, though, across to Lidstrom. Here it comes. Crawford, good take. Rebound. Hit somebody in front, and the Hawks dig it out. Here comes Taves to Kane. Patrick Kane will put it deep. And Corey Crawford with a real nice sequence. Since he gave up a real weak goal halfway through the first period, he has been real solid ever since, although his team has certainly had the better of the chances. Detroit has not been without some opportunities to get on the board again. It hasn't happened. Kane around Cronwall to the corner. Now a jump loose to Eaves. He cleared it to Henrik Zetterberg. Crisscrossing with Hoodler. Zetterberg hangs out with a backhander. Crawford hugging the post. It went in. No goal. It's going to be the call on the ice. Is no goal. The red light went on. I believe the official Chris Rooney is going to say that he blew the whistle. So another disputed play around the net. The Hawks thought they had a goal, which properly was not credited. This, the Wings thought they had a goal. So far, it's no goal. We'll see what happens when we come back.
Take a listen as Henrik Zetterberg enters the offensive zone here when he takes a shot on Corey Crawford. there's referee Chris Rooney. And the referee, folks, if you're not familiar with it, is that anytime they lose sight of the puck, they blow the whistle. Now, there is that time lapse that they take from, and most referees carry their whistle down around their waist. They have it wrapped around their hand. In that situation there, so it goes from his side, and Ian Walsh has got his whistle buried, but again, he goes from his waist to the mouth. That counts as well, and there you see the whistle, you see the referee blowing it. He lost sight of it. I think that puck might have been pinned, Pat, on the pants.
Yes.
And the post.
Yeah.
Of Corey Crawford in there. I think that is the right call.
And Eddie, and we heard the sound of when the whistle did get blown. But it's when the referee meant to blow them. That's the time lapse that you're talking about.
Right.
The second it takes him to get it from maybe his waist level up to his mouth to blow the whistle. So it's when did he mean to blow it? And the Hawks dodge a bullet and still have the lead. 2-1. Mrsak dumped it in.
In that situation, Pat, I didn't get a chance to mention it, but there was 2 against 5. Blackhawks had 5 players back, all 5 players on the ice. The other 3 Red Wings were going for a change. And Zetterberg kind of snaked his way through and just shoveled the puck.
Pisani's long shot is blocked. Came loose to Campbell. Pisani leaves it in the corner. Franz had missed it. Kindle did not. Goes high off the glass to clear it, and it bounced free. And a breakaway from the Wings. Hudler! Goal post! Yuri Hudler drew iron. Now Soleil back to Hudler. Dropped it to Eaves. Here's a backhander. Crawford fought it off. Rebound taken by Hossa. Look at a counterattack. 3-on-2. They've got it. Hossa for Sharp. Hossa to the net. To the backhand. Poked it. Rebound. Kopetsky. Thomas Kopetsky has made it 3-1. What a revolting series of developments for the Red Wings. They thought they had the game tied. No. Now they're down 2.
Well, the Blackhawks were in the middle of a change, and Kindle just throws his puck and finds it way to Yuri Hudler off the crossbar. The Red Wings go for a change. And don't forget, there was a great chance for Patrick Eaves as well, Pat, on the back end that Corey Crawford stopped. Marian Hossa takes his puck hard to the net. And that's the key, is he takes his puck hard to the net. And Thomas Kopetsky, where is he? Right in front of the net with Jimmy Howard down. So 2 great chances, 1 off the crossbar, 1 a backhand by Eaves, and then a 3-on-2. Hossa to Sharpie, back to Hossa and Thomas Kopetsky, the former Red Wing, and that's got to feel awfully good for Thomas Kopetsky.
2 goals in the game for Kopi and 10 for the year. Now a steal in front to Sharp as Hossa got it to him, but the puck eventually picked out of there, and Eaves cleared it to center. Now Keith put it back into Detroit territory. Erickson has a problem with Brower. Rafalski there to bail it out. Fires it out to center. Hudler lost it to Taves. He's checked, and the Wings back in. Mrsak to the corner. Now in behind, Hudler in front. Franzen! What a save by Crawford! Franzen and Troy Broward had a stare down at center, and Franzen then beat Broward to the net. Got a wonderful chance. Crawford a big stop. Now Broward put it in behind. Patrick Kane there. Brower well covered. John Wall against Taves here. Kane got in. Back to Chalmerson in front. Just missing Stahlberg. Picked up by Campbell. Ryan Campbell put on the brakes. Tried to slip it in front, hit the back of the net. And it's cleared out of the Detroit zone. Nicholas Cronwall. Jakob Kindle. Long stretch pass. Draper steps in. Rick wide to Miller. Along Richter. Up high off the glass. Held in by Soleil. Helm is in deep with a wraparound. And a shot actually was blocked before reaching Crawford. Hawks able to get it out of there. C Skilly dumps this one in with 2 minutes remaining in period two. 3-1 in favor of the Hawks. Now Chris Draper in behind for Darren Helm. He was stripped of it beautifully by Jordan Henry, safely getting it out. Helm rolled it loose. Soleil dumped it in. Henry had it taken away, but Tatar could not get to the front of the net. Henry bothered by Emerton in the corner. Now Tatar dug it out of there. Rolled it back. Erickson's long shot is blocked to Bolin. And David Bolin will send it deep.
Good play there by Bolin, recognizing it was a long shift for Letty and Hendry. Get to the red line late in the period. Time and score. Good headiness play there by David Bolin.
A steal here by Kopetsky. Get down to half a minute remaining in period two. Abdelkader lost it. Ooh, Sharp tried to pry it off the boards, could not. And now the Wings clear it to center, but Hossa on the counterattack right back in. Fires! What a save by Howard. He holds on.
Brian Rafalski with a couple of giveaways on this last shift. Well, due to overwhelming fan request, a second, a final printing of One Goal Achieved, Inside Story, the 2010 Stanley Cup Champion Chicago Blackhawks, will be available this week at the Blackhawks store and throughout the Chicagoland, wherever books are sold. A special second edition DVD includes footage from the Blackhawks' stunning opening night banner raising against the Detroit Red Wings. Quantities are limited, so be sure to secure your copy now.
Clock winds down here in period two. Keith rings it around, and that will finish the second. The Blackhawks get two goals from Thomas Kopetsky in period two. They had 12 shots in the period, 27 in the game. The Red Wings had 9 shots in the period, 17 in the game. And we have played 40 minutes in Detroit, Michigan. The Hawks lead 3-1. Hey, Mike Hamlin is behind the Blackhawks bench. The Blackhawks, really, what a second period. I think you've really been pretty good all 40 minutes up till now, have you not?
Oh, for sure. It's we've played solid the last couple games here, so we've carried it over, and we've had a real good week of practice, and you see we had a lot of jumps from the start, so 40 so far, good for 40, but you know, it's a 60-minute game. We have to finish it now.
Hey, Mikey, you talk about that, you know, that time frame off. It's very odd, as you know. I mean, whether it's in the American League or in the National Hockey League, to have that much time off. Can you just zero in maybe a couple of things you guys really tried to emphasize over the course from Monday to Friday?
I think the big thing was our pace. We really wanted to keep our pace up, and we talked about our habits and our details and in our D zone and really with the puck and possessing the puck. It was, but it was our pace. We wanted to keep it up. We wanted to make sure we're keeping our D in the play. And we did a lot of battle drills, a lot of game situation type of drills to keep up that pace. Because it can go either way. I mean, 5 days off, guys could get a little lax. And certainly we didn't. And I think it was a great week of practice.
All right, Javi. Well, hey, keep those towels out of your face. And
yeah, I know.
We want to say congratulations, and I guess we should refer to you as All-Star Mike Hamlin. Yeah, now you'll be part of the coaching staff for the All-Star game in another week.
Thank you.
Have a great time, buddy.
Thanks, guys.
Mike Hamlin behind the Blackhawks bench. There's the guy that scored 2 goals so far today, Thomas Kopetsky. Dave Bolin has the other Blackhawks strike. The one thing we sort of ran out of time with Javi on, I know they worked on the pace that he talked about, but the other thing that's been a problematic area all season long is PK. Now, 2 good things about that today. You've only taken 1 penalty, terrific. And when you did, it was an important time in the game late in the first, and you got through that PK in really pretty good fashion.
I think when you're talking about that and Joel Quenneville and his coaching staff of, you can work on it and practice, but also you do video and making sure that everybody's along the same page. And it's the little things, right, Pat? Clearing the puck 200 feet, blocking shots, making sure that if there is any kind of a scramble, you're back to the middle of the ice and you work yourself out. And I think shift length, how long you're on the ice while shorthanded, is such an important part. You hear coaches tell players, Pat, when you're shorthanded, it should be up and down and off the ice. You don't want to ever get caught when you're shorthanded having too long of a shift. You're at a disadvantage as it is. But when you start extending your shift shorthanded, bad things happen.
Here's Bolin with Pisani to the net. There's the pass. It was broken up before reaching Fernando Pisani. And back comes Darren Helm.
Kindle with another good defensive play.
He's paired up with Soleil, and Ruslan Soleil rolls it in. Miller going wide. Bolin got to him in the corner. Drew Miller trying to pry it loose. There's Helm in behind. He slipped it in front. Kindle, that shot good to stick Pisani. He redirected that point-blank opportunity wide of the net. And Jalmerson sends it up the boards. Pisani got it out. They'll get it in, get off. Now Kindle starts the Red Wings back. Bertuzzi. Well, his pass deflected away from Eves, taken by Seabrook to Kane. It rolled loose to Howard, who will take a whistle.
You mentioned that play by Fernando Pisani, Pat, and the Hawks down low. And we heard Stevie Conroy talking about this in the intermission of Detroit probably going to be taking some chances. And their defenseman jumping in. And there you saw the stick of Fernando Pisani really denying a real good chance. There was some room on that short side on Corey Crawford. Kindle jumping in there, and the Red Wings won a battle along the boards and created a real good chance.
Zetterberg, a wrister, just off the mark. Came back to off the end board. Center, a shot blocked by Duncan Keith. That's a big block at point blank range. He's had a wonderful chance, and Keith in the way. Kane to the other end, dropped it back. Keith into the glove of Howard.
Well, Duncan's had a real strong game.
18 and a half minutes out of the first 40 on the ice for the Hawks. Ice time leader number two.
And talk about that block shot. Here's those crazy boards again, folks. And you talk about the minutes for Duncan Keith, Pat. Remember in the start of the year, in the first eight games, six of the eight for Duncan. He played 30 plus minutes. That only happened once in the next 39 games of playing more than 30 minutes. He did have six where he played 29 plus. I think him and Brent Seabrook have been really, really solid here this afternoon.
Hossa for Sharpie was at his feet. Taken away by Hudler. Yuri Hudler scooped it forward. Ryan Campbell run over. Hudler's pass, though, just out of the reach of Mrazek. It goes back. Rakowski's long one picked off by Jalmerson. And then the Hawks tear it the other way. Knocked down with a high stick and a whistle.
Well, that was Johan Franzen again taking a run at Ryan Campbell. It hit hard in the first period there, but Campbell taking a hit to make a play. And you see the numbers for Franzen.
Now they fight for a faceoff, which is eventually cleared to center ice. Skilly dumped it back in. Dowell from the corner. And it knocked off his stick, and Emmerton got it out of there. Jordan Hendry rolled it up the boards. Skilly got as far as center. Emmerton came back in the offensive zone, shooting into the glove and out of the glove, but covered by Corey Crawford. We touched on this earlier today, Eddie, but really remarkable what the Red Wings have been able to do. When the Hawks are healthy. Detroit without Pavel Datsyuk, who might be as good without the puck as he is with it. Dan Cleary, one of their top goal scorers. Thomas Holmstrom, a real physical force. Valtteri Filppula isn't available. Brad Stewart isn't available. These guys have been decimated. And yet they come into this game having gone 5-2-1. It's really remarkable what they've been able to do with some pretty key components unavailable. I'm just looking back. Since Pavel Datsyuk, as good a player as they have, went out of the lineup, their record is 9-4-2. So you got to tip your hat to Mike Babcock and really the whole Red Wing organization, but they seem to be able to plug pieces in when needed. No matter who they lose, and they have lost some pretty important guys.
Looks like they're Cleary and Datsyuk who skated before this afternoon game. Possibly could be back right after the All-Star break next weekend.
Kasani fights through traffic to center the ball right into the forehand. What a save by Howard! If Howard was 2 inches shorter, that's a goal. He needed every inch of his left leg for that one. And now Draper starts the Red Wings back. Helm into the zone. Trying to get to the goal. Seabrook cut him off. Helm hangs on. And good back pressure by Kane with a takeaway. Patrick Kane looks back to Brouwer. Here's the shot. Fired it wide. Rebound Taves to Seabrook. Now they battle on the boards. Taves to Brouwer. Checked by Cronwall. Franzen took it away and the Wings come out. Henrik Zetterberg to Nick Lidstrom. Back for Zetterberg. Well covered by Keith and jumped into the air. And then the glove of Crawford.
Oh, the great chance for Dave Bolin because it was the effort, the extra effort of Fernando Pisani. Watch this effort, folks. All you young hockey players out there, you want to win a battle? I mean, he just pushes off Chris Draper there, and here comes Davey Bolin. Little fake to the backhand forehand, not able to elevate the puck, but just a great chance because of the effort by Fernando Pisani through the middle of the ice. And then Brouwer had a great chance bat on that 3-on-2. Mm-hmm. That lane opened up because Jonathan Toews went hard to the net and opened up the lane.
Hossa with a one-timer and a post-to-post save by Jimmy Howard.
A little fake there by Sharpie, and Marian Hossa not able to get 100% complete connection on that shot. He had Jimmy Howard down, and there you see Haas kind of looking up a little bit, knowing he had a glorious chance after a real good play by Kopetsky to get the puck to Patrick Sharp, and a chance for Hossa.
Now the Wings head out. Erickson to Mrazek. Jan Mrazek steps in. He's checked. Sharp took him right off the puck, and Kopetsky hoisting it back the other way. Hossa hustling. Erickson there to meet him. And back comes Hudler to Rafalski. A long wrist shot, blocked away by Crawford. Back toward Mrazek. He's hit hard by Skilly in the corner. Jalmerson the other way will dump it. Now Hudler into the Blackhawk zone. Again, some back pressure by Stalbert. And haven't the Hawks been great at that today? Hustling back defensively, creating some good back pressure on the puck carrier.
Yeah, not giving the offensive player with the puck any time. That's one area where the game has changed a lot here, Pat. Probably in the last, I mean, probably 8 to 10 years, where usually when if you were a back checker and you didn't have the puck carrier by the red line, you left them for the defense and then you let them play one-on-one. And now all of a sudden players forwards are coming back and they're helping to be all the way back. You talk about the back pressure, that's that situation. And you're right, the Hawks have had a lot of jump in their step, and playing with the lead certainly helps, but I think, you know, the 5 days off has a lot to do with that as well. And you feel like you got shot out of a cannon every time you jump onto that ice. And the Hawks have done a good job of rolling the lines, and you got yourself a little bit of cushion. And it gives, you know, more players and the fourth line guys an opportunity to play a little bit.
Zetterberg. We talked about the Detroit injuries and about timeout Quenneville after that icing call. So Blackhawks will utilize their one allotted timeout here. But it's time to talk about the Red Wings, and we mentioned the numerous injuries that they've had to some really, really important guys. But Henrik Zetterberg, in the last 15 games that he's played, there's been only one where he didn't get at least a point. So increased attention from their opponents because everybody knows you got to slow this guy down, and still nobody seems to be able to do it.
He just has that ability to take a situation, Pat, and create a positive, regardless if it's 200 feet away from the opposing net or within 10 feet. Just complete players. You talk about it, Jonathan Toews, Henrik Zetterberg, Pavel Datsyuk. And those type of players are so important and really so special.
52 points, 47 games for Zetterberg so far this season.
Advantage here, Pat, for the Red Wings.
Stahlberg, no. Kastani's going to come in on the draw against Zetterberg. Jordal got tossed. Good job by Fernando Pisani. He tied up Zetterberg beautifully. And Stahlberg able to scoop it the other way. Short of center when he did though. Hawks again wanting to change and cannot.
Well, drive with Jonathan Toews and Patrick Kane. Drive, visit your local Chevy dealer or ChevyDrivesChicago.com.
Now ready. Zetterberg won that draw from Dow. Lidstrom put it up the boards. Hoodler for Zetterberg just out of his reach. He shoots one. What a save by Crawford. It's loose. Then Crawford able to locate and cover. 13-23. They're going to turn.
How many goals do the Hawks have?
Three.
All right.
Has a two-goal lead here. As Franz and Rister. Crawford's right shoulder able to fight it off, and he held on. But a couple of offensive zone faceoff wins here for Detroit of late.
Man, look at Corey Crawford, Pat, and there's been some great rookie performances so far to this point. You think about Jeff Skinner in Carolina, Logan Couture in San Jose, Cam Fowler with Anaheim. And Corey Crawford's right up there in the conversation piece as far as, you know, being a guy that would be considered for that honor.
Got to be if he keeps up this pace. Of course, he barely played in the early part of the season. Right. Now he's taken over the number one role for Quenneville's team, and he's really been on a marvelous run after a sluggish start. Good speed here. Helm, Campbell able to recover and chase down the loose puck. Helm from the corner. Two Hawks got to him. Jalmerson's got control.
Yeah, Helm had a chance to take that puck to the net there, Pat. Yeah, maybe he was maybe looking for a little better play in that situation, and he stopped, and that allowed the Hawks and close down on the real speedy Helm.
Erickson pressured by Toews, who took it away to Brouwer. Erickson then got it back. Out comes Cronwall. Bertuzzi dropped it back. Eaves along. Richard kicked away. Crawford. Rebound. Cronwall. Crawford! Crawford on Cronwall! And it's still 3-1.
Opportunity. The Hawks give up an odd man situation. Again, defenseman jumping in. Patrick Eaves. And there's Cronwall, defenseman jumping in. And Corey Crawford again. Follow the puck, kicks it out. Not a great rebound, especially in that high slot area. And look at Nicholas Cronwall. Palms to the Joe Louis roof. And opportunities. A couple galore. Another faceoff one.
Here's a tip. Oh, good save and a redirect. Crawford with a right pad flashing out. Now a Zetterberg steal. He's in. Crawford beat him. Rebound. Hit Crawford and bounced loose. Finally, Dahl got it to Kane. Patrick Kane put it in there. Rolling to Howard. He'll play it. And the Wings turn it over. Brouwer It was checked though by Cronwall. Brower chased it down, slipped it toward Kane, then Taves. Patrick Kane with Keith sneaking in. Kane spins toward the middle. Kane hangs on. Taves in behind. Brower's in front there at the pass. He scores! Jonathan Taves sets up Troy Brower, and the Blackhawks have a 4-1 bulge.
Well, Troy Brower, who scored a couple of goals in the Hawks' last game against the Nashville Predators. Kaner playing keep away. Killing the clock, gets his puck down low. Great support there from Jonathan Taves and a breakdown defensively. Pat, let's go back to the stop. Keep it right here. Watch the stick from the shot from the Detroit Red Wings. We talk about key stops at a time. The game's 3-1, right? Shot is wide off the stick. And look at Corey Crawford stick that toe out. Mm. Timely saves, and then the Hawks come right back and get a 3-goal cushion.
Wow, what a turn of events. Instead of being down one, the Wings down three. And how often does it happen? A big save at one end, followed in short order by a goal at the other.
Yeah, face-off loss and a created opportunity. Look at Jonathan Taves. Head up all the way there, Pat. And I'm not sure where Nicholas Cronwall was going on that. I think he anticipated Johnny to go back the other way. He left the front. Erickson got mesmerized, and that was it. Have you seen Nicholas Lidstrom at all, Pat?
Good point. I don't think that he's been on the ice in the third period. I cannot recall him being out there.
And I'm just trying to look real quick, give a quick count on the Red Wing bench, but I don't remember, let alone hearing you call his name, but seeing him at all.
Yeah. Campbell goes across to Johnerson, a long one, up off the glass. And certainly in this type of scenario, with the Wings being down a couple coming into the third, I mean, he would likely play 9 to 10 minutes in this third period. Yeah, so
I do see him on the bench, and I counted real quick, so I do see the C on the chest there of Nicholas Lidstrom, but it, I mean, to me, it seems like he hasn't played at all in this period.
It does. Here's a coast-to-coast rush. Crawford with a right pad. Oh, and then the net jammed off the moorings. Tatar with lightning speed flying up the right side. Got to the goal, but Crawford denies.
At the end of this play, watch how many Blackhawks you see right in front of Corey Crawford. There's three. There's four Blackhawk defenders. And Marian Hossa coming in and making Justin Abdelkader pay a price in front of the net. But speed to the outside as Tatar goes wide. And Corey Crawford holding that ground. But again, a lot of help coming from the Blackhawk forwards and helping out the D in front of their goaltender.
Now a corner battle results in Chicago possession. Out comes Keith. Rafalski pressured by Hossa. Now Erickson. And a turnover to Hossa. Looks to center. That pass broken up. Erickson put it up the boards. And Stahlberg tried to get to the middle, but Helm got it back. We've reached the halfway point of the third. 4-1 in favor of the Hawks. Trying to draw to within 8 points of Detroit in the Western Conference. And the division. Helm up the ice. Soleil pulls up. Shoots one. That might have been blocked out in front of the net. It bounced to Dowell. And his pass deflected off a stick. Out of play. 9 minutes remain in the third. Chicago 4, Detroit 1. Hall of Famer Nicholas Lidstrom, who has not been much in evidence here in this third period for a team that was trailing by a couple of goals coming in, now down three. I can guarantee you one thing. There are no Hawks forwards or members of the coaching staff who are upset watching the picture we just showed you. He's sitting over there in front of the backup goalie. They won't mind if he stays right there.
That's the safest place. They're probably applauding on the inside. Well, you know what? Forget it. Applauding on the outside with that.
Yeah.
He's played actually earlier in this period, played 2 minutes. And didn't notice, man. Well, I guess he must have heard us. Because he hasn't played Pat in the last 5 minutes for sure.
Easily. Oh, yes. It's interesting. Mike Babcock, at the start of the season, was talking as if he was going to try. I mean, here's an elder statesman. He's been around a long time and certainly still one of the premier defensemen in the league. In fact, you're talking about Rookie of the Year voting. Right. I think if the Norris voting begins today, I mean, he's certainly
yes.
in the conversation and likely a finalist, I believe. But it was funny, Babcock earlier this season was saying, I would like to be able to cut down his typical minutes a little, you know, just over the course of the season. He thought that would be very helpful to the Wings. Then I saw a quote from him, the head coach, 2 or 3 weeks ago, when somebody asked him after a game that Lidstrom had played 29 minutes. Well, what happened there? And the coach's comment was, hey, we don't have anything solidified yet. If I got to play him 29, I'm going to play him 29. But anyway, he's gone away from that here today, where it would appear that Lidstrom's minutes will be down around 23, 24, something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, Jonathan Toews, Pat, only had some sort of a collision in behind the net. And it took Johnny a while to get back. There's Toews right there. And a stick of of Nicholas Lidstrom. And I kind of caught him off guard. And he just kind of labored to get back to the bench. And you saw him, you know, wincing a little bit. And got a little bit of attention from Mike Gapski.
Helm driving the goal. Good recovery by Dave Bolden. Campbell got beat to the outside. Bolden recovered, made a fine defensive play. Erickson. It around. And Hjalmarsson for Bickell. And finally, the Hawks able to bounce it back the other way. Campbell. To a circling Henry, then Sharp. Puck possession here for the Hawks, who love this with a 3-goal lead. Finally, Miller. Oh, good. Again, back pressure from Sharp to take it away. And the Wings move back in offside. Frustration seems to be building a little bit here for the home side, who've had some opportunities, but been tough for them to get a lot of good chances on Corey Crawford here in the third.
Well, Pat, I know you and I would like to send out an entire Blackhawk organization. Annie Cammons, the youth hockey director for the Blackhawks, like to send out our condolences to Joe and Megan Keaton of Evanston. Joe's a head coach there at the Evanston youth hockey program, and understand they lost their 5-week-old child, Megan. Joseph Michael Heaton, excuse me, earlier this week, so we'd like to send our condolences to the Heaton family. Joe and Megan, we're certainly thinking about it.
Absolutely. Terrible tragedy, and certainly hope that that spirit will live on with you. Jordan Henry. This pairing, really, that for a while, Eddie, I think you could say for a long part of this season, the so-called third pairing, sure. been something that the Hawks of Light have been wanting to get settled down, and I think you make a pretty good case that the last few weeks that has started to happen.
A different look on the back end. You still got Nick Boynton back there that brings you a little bit of toughness. It'll be interesting to see tomorrow, but I don't think there's any doubt that. Let's see a lineup change tomorrow for the Flyers when they come into town. I mean, they have some guys that aren't afraid to, you know, drop the gloves, play a little bit of that rough style. And We still got John Scott back there as well. He hasn't played a lot of defense in the last little while. Early in the year he did, but you know, that defensive pair, to your point, of Nick Leddy and Jordan Hendry, really brought a different look, a different dimension on the back end, be able to make some plays. Good hit there by Jack Skilly on Abdelkader. Wisconsin Badger against a former Spartan. How dare you? He's a Packer fan anyways.
Yeah, that's a give it to him. Joe Quenneville's team, after today, will have taken 11 points out of the last 12 with the current lineup. You're playing tomorrow against the team you played in the finals, a team that doesn't mind giving you the business. And in a game this week, they had a fight-filled contest against Ottawa. Now, do you think there'd be serious consideration given to making some lineup changes tomorrow?
Yeah, I think so. I think, you know, one for sure, just to, you know, just to have it. And, you know, and Joel's, you know, he's made lineup changes when, you know, the team has been going well and on a nice streak like you mentioned, Pat. So, you know, I would, there's a penalty coming up. But I would not be surprised to see a lineup change of some sort to, you know, have that different look, so to speak. As the Hawks will get another power play opportunity as the veteran Draper is in the box.
Well, Eddie, it's a boarding call on Draper, and this is the third penalty of the game against the Red Wings. I'm not sure you could put any one of the three in the category of a good penalty.
Right. And I think that one on there, in Draper's defense there, Pat, just on a quick replay, and from what I saw live, was Skilly saw him coming, he kind of ducked a little bit. And now, granted, Draper's stick, and we're going to get a chance to take another look at that, because I want to ask you a question about that. But I think as he was going to make the hit, Jack Skilly kind of ducked, and, you know, the shoulder hit or the head hit, you know, with the arms. We'll get a chance to take another look at that. And let me throw that up for a little discussion here in this 4-1 lead for the Hawks.
Osa on the power play, which is converted twice. Oh, that pass just missed. Kopetsky going for a hat trick today. Sharp, Seabrook's one-timer soaked up by Jimmy Howard. Let's go back.
We're going to go back here, Pat. And once he gets close, here's Chris Draper. Now stop it here. Look where his stick is. It's up in this area here. Do you think, Pat, we ever get to a situation where if guys make contact with a player and the stick is above the waist that they automatically call a penalty? You know, because when your stick is here, you're inevitably going to hit somebody really high when your stick is up here. In that situation, you know, Skilly was, I mean, he was trying to get out of the way. But I guess the question I have for you is, you're going to get to a situation when you hit guys, you got to make sure that your stick is below your waist?
Honestly, I think that's a possibility that may be somewhere down the road. I mean, you look what happened after the lockout and the standard. I mean, you and I remember really good defensive forwards saying to us that if you're within a stick length of a guy, right, you've got him. Yeah. Well, of course, that doesn't work anymore. You have to be able to skate and stay with him that way. You can't hook and hold and rodeo your way up and down the ice. So with the hot button issue in the NHL nowadays being headshots, that's nothing like that.
Sure.
But I wonder if it might be somewhere down the road where something like that might be strongly considered, because certainly in the attempt and the success of opening up the game the way the league has since the lockout, I mean, it's been a marvelous transformation where now a one-goal lead doesn't mean you're going to win the game automatically going into the third period.
And I think that's the teaching aspect, Pat, of all coaches and, you know, players that are students of the game. And we try to do that at the Blackhawk Youth Hockey Camps, of teaching players, look, when you're finishing your check, I mean, your stick needs to be on the ice. The puck is not optional when you're going to be physical. And you want to set, first of all, you can't hit anybody if they don't have the puck. So in order to separate the player from the puck, you want to kind of target the hands and the arms to separate. Now, you want to get body on body. But the point is that the stick is up in the air. chances are is you're going to have the penalty here on Jalmerson. He's not
he's mad. He cleared around the boards and hit the referee. That's what led to the... Then he said, really, that's your fault. He had the puck around the boards and hit the skates of the referee. And Ian Walsh is saying, well, where do you want me to go?
Well, there's Corey Crawford. Turns the puck over. Puck will come back down there from Thomas Kopetsky. And he actually, Ian Walsh actually tried to jump out of the way there, Pat. And there you see the penalty on Zetterberg, and Jalmerson not happy. But, you know, just finishing up on that thought of teaching, keeping the stick down. You can still make contact if your stick is on the ice. But that's something I thought a lot about over the course of the last little while with all these head hits, Pat. And, you know, I think you do get to a situation where, and players are so smart in this league. I mean, they will adapt. If you say, look, if you can't make contact with your stick above your waist, it'll be fine, and then all of a sudden it'll do it. But now players get so reckless. You know, you got to make full contact.
Good save by Crawford on the one-timer from Zetterberg. I'm glad you brought it up. I mean, I really hadn't considered something like that. And being the wily hockey expert that you are, I
think it'd be interesting. I really would. And I think you would eliminate, and I think it becomes pretty easy, Pat. I mean, somebody makes contact and the stick is, you know, I don't know what you want to call it, chest, whatever it is. If your stick's up here, it's automatically going to be a penalty. And I think players would adapt, and I think you can see a lot of things cleaned up.
Lidstrom's one timer, good block, Dowell. Now they jam it back toward Lidstrom. Dropped it across. Hoover's one timer. Soaked up by Crawford. He thought he had it, but Franzen jammed it just off his pads. Now Hoover keeping it in. Here's Lidstrom. Walks in with a shot. Good block, Seabrook. Hoover gets it back for Detroit. Zetterberg with Lidstrom going back door. There's Franzen with a stop attempt. And that's stopped by Crawford. And deflected out of play with a minute of power play time remaining.
Well, Pat, you picked it up. One shot blocked by Jake Dowell. One shot blocked by Brent Seabrook. Here's an opportunity. Corey Crawford kind of, I don't know if you really realize where that puck was. Kind of swatted at it and laid there. And Franzen standing right in front of the net. But the Hawks paying a price. Up by three late in the game. Taking a lot of pride in a penalty kill. Something that they want to improve on. And that's infectious. Those type of things, Pat, you played right to the end. You get in the line. You don't lay it. You don't flamingo it. You get right in the way. And nice job there by Dowell and Brent Seabrook. Again, I go back. I think Seabrook and Keith have been really, really sharp here today.
A redirect from Advocator went over top of the net. Now Lidstrom kept it in. Rostowski with a hot pass. Winds up all the way across the ice. Taken by Eves. Now Cronwall. Lidstrom a good keep. Back toward Cronwall. Half a minute for the power play. Centering pass. Off a stick and up off the netting. Out of play. 74 seconds left in the game. The Blackhawks will beat Detroit for the second time in three get-togethers, and still three more meetings between these bitter foes.
That's how we close out the end of the year, right? Last two games.
Back to back,
yeah,
right?
Home and home, yeah.
Wings win a draw. Rafalski shot it wide. Zetterberg moves in. Zetterberg wants Hoover, who was back door, but the pass was tipped. Franzen to Zetterberg. Here's a one-timer, Rafalski wide. Now a backhand shot was blocked with Crawford spinning back into his own net. Seemed to be a little troublesome staying on his feet there momentarily. Rafalski keeps it in. Good pressure by Brouwer to get it out. The Hawks penalty over. Both teams back at full strength. Zetterberg, hot pass in front. Oh, Crawford with the left arm might have gotten iron as well. Cromwell's had a couple of wonderful chances today. Crawford won that confrontation. Kane to the other end. Dropped it to Sharp. Kopetsky, they try to get him not hat trick opportunity. Rafalski for Detroit got it to Franzen. And we go to the Final few seconds of the game. Draper, or I should say Mrazek, lost it. Centering pass to front. And a last second bid denied by Corey Crawford. How about Corey Crawford now has played 26 games for the Hawks. In 18 of them, two goals or fewer.
Terrific. Timely saves. And the Red Wings were not out of it when the game was 3-1. The opportunity. Faceoff win for the Red Wings. Big stop off the toe, and Hawks come right back and score that fourth goal. And Pat, one thing I noticed here in this last, and with everybody come out and congratulating Corey Crawford, I did not see Jonathan Toews come off the bench there, so something to keep an eye out for tomorrow. And here's that opportunity. Glove and post and out for the Red Wings.
19 shots in the third period for Detroit. None went in. 36 in the game. One went in. The Blackhawks beat the Wings 4-1.